Most of us will already be familiar with our next guest. He's one of Aotearoa's biggest performing artists, and now he's here to talk about his new book, Impossible, and the incredibly raw, brave story he's sharing for the very first time. We're so thrilled to have award-winning musician Stan Walker with us today. Morena e te korokoro tui.
Morena, tamari.
Tēnei au, e mihi ana ki a koe, ki o maunga, ki o marae. It is a real pleasure to have you here on the show with us today. Now, just in that wide shot, we saw that there was a camera crew in here. They're following you around. What's going on?
Yeah, I'm filming my whānau.
Okay.
Now, everyday life, it's got to be interesting.
Yeah.
Especially my whānau being on camera. I'm like, oh.
Love it. So how are you?
Yeah,
Before we start talking about the book, how are things going?
It's been incredible. Like, I think, just life has actually been incredible since lockdown. I think lockdown was actually probably one of the best things that ever happened to me this year. So just learned a lot.
Oh,
just being exposed to myself in a whole different way, exposed to everything, and just had time to actually reset. And I haven't done that since I started.
Yeah.
So, like, that was a real time of, like, you know, and the whole world was in it together.
Yeah.
I mean, other places obviously a lot longer, but it was awesome. It was mean.
Your book is coming out on the 14th of October, so it's not in stores yet. And I had the opportunity to get an advanced copy and read it, and it's hard. It's beautiful, it's revealing, it's full of hope and redemption, but it's really raw and it's really hard. So for you, it's not out yet. How are you feeling about people exposing yourself to people?
Well, if nobody else is going to do it, I guess I'll do it. I mean, I've had everything said about me under the sun, so, like, for me, I think it was a release for my own self. I got to learn a lot about myself, especially as a kid, but I felt like it's time. I mean, I've lived a whole life, and I've seen a whole life in 30 years of so many things
that you
swept
shouldn't
under the carpet, and not just me. People around me, people I was brought up with, everywhere I've gone, I've met people just like me. I'm just so grateful and blessed that I'm free from all of that. Now it's time for everybody else to be free, and it's like, man, rip that carpet up and see what's there, and let's actually deal with it.
When you say you're free, is that because telling your story? And there's a piece in there where you talk about telling your mum and dad about the sexual abuse that you suffered over years. So is that the part that's freeing for you, is actually being able to say, this is me, this is it?
I think everything. It's not just that. I think even for me, this last 12 years, is since I've become an artist, since Idol, that's been a harder journey than my childhood. Like I've said
what?
This over
Why?
And... Because I'm an adult now, and I understand and can comprehend stuff as an adult, and I have to adult.
Yeah.
Whereas a kid, I had resilience. I felt like I was more strong as a kid because you kind of get over stuff and you kind of don't know defeat like we do as an adult. It's like, you know, the difference between a kid getting sick and they're like, oh, you know, that's kind of just like airy-fairy. We're adults, we find out we're sick, everything, like our world comes tumbling in.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
For me, as an adult, going through the things as an adult has been harder as a kid. I thought I was prepared coming into this industry because of my childhood, but it's a whole different ball game. Like, my whole life is now broadcasted, and everything that I go through, I'm like, people are watching.
Mm.
So I have to hide that. I never had to hide, like, you know, I had to hide it in a different way as a kid. So,
I think it's beautiful because throughout the book, you talk about the different things that happened to you, the physical abuse, the emotional abuse, but you also reflect, as you're just talking about, as an adult, back on those times, and you're very forgiving of the people who inflicted those things on you and what their history was and how that impacted you.
I think for me, it's like I've had this incredible life, even though, you know, I've had my ups and downs. I'm sure everybody else has. But for me, I've gained so much perspective. Just travelling the world, meeting different people, you know, especially being brought up on the marae and then being brought up on farms in Australia. It's kind of the same thing. My family always went together, but actually stepping outside of that village life and just being surrounded by only your whānau, I've had to I've met some of the most incredible people around the whole world that have given me different perspective, especially when it comes to, like, you know, past trauma, intergenerational cycles, and like, for me, like, there's a whakapapa to every action, there's a whakapapa to everything that somebody does, and I feel like, wouldn't you rather know their whakapapa so that we can deal with it and cut off at the root rather than just punish people? Or just, like, you know, like, stuff you did this to me, like, I feel like it's so much more deeper than that.
So what was it like then? I'm assuming Mum and Dad read the book.
Yeah.
Because by exposing yourself, you're also exposing Mum and Dad.
Yeah.
So how did they feel when they knew that you wanted to do this and then reading the book?
They knew. They knew from the get-go.
Yeah.
They've known, like, ever since I've started when I was 18, I'm, like, 30 soon, this month. And they knew that coming into this life that my purpose and my calling was so much bigger than our situations
you
or our past.
You knew that at 8 too, didn't you?
Oh, I
you
knew that. I knew
yeah.
it. And in order for healing to take place, you have to kind of call it as it is. And I feel like in this country or just around the world in general, people are too scared to call a spade a spade. That's why people are falling. That's why our own people in this country are falling through the cracks, they're falling by the wayside because people can't actually, they're not allowing them to have that power to call it what it is, whatever that is. And so my mum and dad were sweet as, but at the same time, my mum and dad learnt for the first time who I am as a whole, as a person. And my dad rang me up and he's like, son, oh son, you're amazing, son. He goes, beautiful. I get it now, I get it. And I was just like, finally.
Nah. But isn't that beautiful to say that, you know, he sees you for all of who
yeah.
you are. And as a child growing up, why you were the way that you
yeah.
were. It must be beautiful knowing, and when you read this book, you understand this relationship between you and your dad. And here he is calling you saying, I get you now, son. I get
yeah, it's so beautiful. And, like, I mean, people just see all the past stuff, but my dad's actually my hero. Like, I'm just so, like, when I look at the past stuff, like, me and my dad and my brothers, we laugh about it because it seems laughable because it doesn't seem like
real.
Like, it doesn't even seem real to us. But my dad, from being, like, don't even know how to be a dad and don't even know how to be a husband, is the most incredible father I've ever met. And he fathers all these young men. He's, like, real shameless. He goes up to people on the street, goes, hey, bro, and they turn around looking at him. And he goes, can you play rugby? 2 months later, they're living with them, calling him Papa. And, like, that's the kind of man he's become.
Yeah.
So, yeah, he's the man.
There's so many other things that I want to talk about because your book is fascinating, and as I say, it's really raw, and I had to put it down at times because I felt it.
Yeah, yeah.
Obviously, you know, not to that extent, but, you know, it was hard, but it's just beautiful too, the way that you have looked at things with a heart of forgiveness as well. Before we wrap things up, I want to ask you about your song Big, or Bigger, out Tua, and where that came from, because I'm assuming that's come as a result of you telling your story.
Honestly, this song just kind of came out of nowhere. My mate from America, Parson, he's an artist, and we did the song, we did the cover, Tennessee Whiskey.
Yes.
Sent over this demo, and I was just like, you know, recording and just doing my own little things and changing things up, and I recorded it, and then when we were in lockdown, as I was editing, like, I was editing the book, just going over and making sure that everything was right because I've only got one chance to tell the story, it hit me and it just reminded me of my purpose because, like, even lockdown was incredible. I just kind of had lost my way and I was just like, what's the point? Like, you know, and a few things, like, this is just me, I'm always up and down because that's just, I'm like a bipolar kind of person, like, I'm just, everything's intense, everything's either really great or, you know, but that's just who I am. And it just hit me so hard, and I just remember being that 8-year-old kid on my hill pretending that I'm singing to thousands of people, and now I'm going back to my hill to get my 8-year-old nephew to be the younger version of me, and I'm like, wow, this is a full circle moment of like impossible becoming possible, and now the next generation, hopefully my legacy will be so much more greater than what I have and what I am, and I'm just a byproduct of all the sacrifices of everybody who went before me. And now my nephews and nieces, like, they're on video clips. Like my niece, we did tour.
Yeah.
And I had my bro Tawaroa Kawana to whakamaori it, and yeah. We're going through the process of like, because you know intentions are big in te ao Māori and like te reo Māori, and so we're doing you know tuaki te ārai. And it was just incredible. And my niece, I was looking after, it was my day to babysit her for school holidays. I was like, I'll come in the shooting the whole time. She's like, Uncle, let's just go, come
let's on.
And then I said, Bubba, you want to jump in? And she jumped in. Honest to God, I started crying because that song is everything of like, she's the next generation. Like, that's, I wish I was that age and I had someone like me to come in. She's just so privileged. She's like, oh, I'm on another song. I'm like, she goes to her dad, I'm on iTunes before you, Dad. I'm on Spotify before you.
Oh, I love our babies. I love it. And I can see the love and that moment when you're looking at her when she's doing that last part in that waiata, a tāhua rawa. Nō reira, he mihi aroha tēnei ki a koe, he morehu koe. You are a survivor. This book is beautiful. As tough as it is, the messages that are in there are beautiful, and I want to thank you for telling your story.
Kia ora.
Tēnā koe.
Tēnā koe.